Hi, welcome to ODE YouTube channel. Today I'm going to review a Chinese pen. So, if you usually like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. It's really important for me to grow on YouTube. So, the pen that I'm reviewing today, I think it is no mystery because it says there D-Like. So, this is a D-Like pen. And let's open this box. It comes inside this little tin box, and not that little, it's quite big actually. And here it is, the pen. This is the D-Like TN Element Brass. So it is a pen made of brass, and it is a very heavy one because it is all made of brass. Very heavy, but not a pen that you can't hold. No, but really, it is heavy. It's not very big, but heavy for the size of it. Now, what do you have here? You have a very simple pen that has this cap that is quite short for the whole size of the pen, and it has all over the pen. And let me try to show you this. I don't know if I will be able to. It has this like spiral pattern engraved on it, so it has texture. I don't know if you can hear the fingernail rubbing around this texture. This pen is very simple shaped, cylindrical with curved ends. It has a screw there to post the cap, and it is made of brass, nothing more to it. The pen and caps around 2.5 turns, and then it posts quite securely there on the threads, and you have to screw it more there. And you have a nib, a steel nib, like a number 5 nib that says D-Like super quality, and this is an M nib. I don't know if it's written anywhere. It's there on the feet, M nib, very simple one with these hourglass shaped section, also made of brass. And here you have, it has a converter, this kind of Chinese converters that are quite good. The pen comes like this, like you can see here, very shiny, but if you use it for a while, it will start oxidating and getting like this, with this kind of color. So if you like this, it's a pen that you may like. If you don't, so maybe it's not the right pen for you. But when you're looking to this pen, what does it remind you of? I would say the Caveco Sport. This one is the Wave, the Caveco Lilliput, sorry. This is the Wave, the Brass Wave version. So it has these patterns, but you have a straight one. I also have a one made of copper that doesn't have these waves all around the pen. And you can see it is the same philosophy of pen. Very simple shape with domed hands, and then you can post the pen securely by screwing the cap on the bottom of the barrel. And here you have it posted with a small section and a number 5 nib. So many of you may say this is a copy of the Caveco Lilliput, and I would say that it is pretty much a copy of the Caveco Lilliput, but it is a bigger pen. The differences that you can find between the Caveco Lilliput and that one is that the pen is bigger, and then the nib looks smaller than it should on this pen. I think the number 5 nib on the Lilliput looks great because it is a smaller pen, so it is a big nib. And also on this pen, the it is bigger, so it allows to have a full-size international converter or ink cartridge, or two ink cartridges inside. This one only allows for a short international ink cartridge, but this is a very much, it is heavy, but it for its size, but it is a smaller and lighter pen to carry in a pocket than this one. Both will be very sturdy. They will survive almost anything. Very heavy, very well made. So I think it's it. I don't have a Caveco Supra, which is a bigger version and a fatter version of the Caveco Lilliput, to put against this one. I hope I'll get one soon. But the Caveco Supra, maybe this is a copy of the Caveco Supra. However, the Caveco Supra has the advantage of being a bigger pen, like this, I think. But it has a removable extra section that allows the pen to be smaller, or to take long international cartridges, or to have just a short one, but by being smaller, by removing a section, which is a nice feature. And also, on the Caveco Supra, you have a number 6 nib, which I think it's much more balance for a pen like this. However, this pen, you can buy it online from China for 15 or a little less euros. So for that price, isn't this a good pen? Yes, it is a great pen. You can take it anywhere and it is very, very sturdy. Does it look really impressive in its shape? Not that much, and I don't really love this knurled thing. I would prefer it to be straight. I think there is another version that is completely flat, I believe, but I've seen only pictures online, which is an oxidized version. It comes already with a patina, and I think it will have some coating of a clear... it has some kind of a clear coating to avoid the patina to go away. And now, when you compare this pen with two other pens that I usually compare my pens with, you have the Parker Centennial Blue Fold and the Lamy Safari, and you see it is a much slimmer pen and also shorter one. When you uncap the Centennial Blue Fold, the Lamy, and also the Lilliput, you'll see the Dilek, you'll see that the Dilek is shorter, but not that short. And if you post it, it will become really a large pen. I don't really think that this pen needs to be posted. I would only post this pen if I really like to post my pens. I don't, unless they are very short, so I wouldn't post usually this pen. It is long enough to write with like this. And if I was really afraid of losing the cap. Otherwise, I would prefer to use it like this. And I will show it now on paper. And here we have the pen and the paper, and let's start doing it. First thing that I have to say is that it does this. This pen rolls off your desk. It won't break if it hits the ground. Maybe it will break the ground, but there is no roll stopper that you can put in this pen, at least by now, or anything that I could find that was specifically made for this pen. So this is the Dilek TN Element Brass. It has a M steel nib. First thing I have to notice is that it has these threads that are quite sharp, but I prefer to hold the pen like this. I'm used to do it with the Cavecos, and I hold this pen the same way, so I don't find this unpleasant. But if you prefer to hold the pen higher, maybe this is not okay for you. They are a little sharp and they can hurt a little bit your fingers when writing. The ink inside is the discontinued Parker Quink Brown, and the paper is the usual Rhodia Dot Pad. And what I have to say about this pen, it writes really, 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 really well. It is very smooth, almost no feedback, with a generous line. It is an M, it's not too fat for an M. There's not a lot of line variation, but if you press it harder, you can see the difference here with pressure and with just no pressure. And you can write upside down, and you have a much more almost invisible line and thinner, and the pen will start skipping, but you can write with it upside down, so you go from an extra fine or a fine to a medium and a fat medium, I wouldn't say a broad. This pen really puts a good amount of ink on paper. As you can see, it really smears well, and it's such a pleasure to put so much ink on paper. I'm not really a big fan of what you call wet noodles, but this is a kind of that pen. It really writes wet, and the nib is very well tuned, and it costs only 15 euros or maybe a little less by now. So is this a good pen? Yes, it is. Is it a copy of the design of the Café Lilliput? Unfortunately, yes, but it works. So if this is what you want, it's a nice thing. The nib and feed can screw out, so you can put some other nib and feed color there, because you can exchange if you find a compatible one. I don't know which will be compatible, but if you do, it's really easy to exchange. And what I would say is I would prefer it to be a number 6 nib. I think the number 5 nib is too small for this pen. However, it is a very, very good pen, and if you want to have a pen that will not break, will be last a long time, and will have some patina along the time, this is the pen for you. So I have to thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and come back for the next video. Bye.